I want to start this video by covering some of the basics of lenses, and therefore, we begin with a simple circle. I don't think this is going to work out as I planned. Hold on, I got an idea. Ah, perfect. Now I'm going to cut away a part of the circle, and in order for a better visualization, I also change its color. Now that is a lens. To be more specific, it's a plano convex lens. In order to keep things simple and this video to a reasonable length, we have to use some approximations. For example, everything I'm going to tell you theoretically only applies to very thin lenses. However, you can also apply all of that to thicker lenses and still get usable results. Now, first order of business, we are going to shine some light onto our lens. A convex lens has a property that if the incoming rays of light are parallel to each other, they are going to be focused in one point, the so-called focal point. The distance from the lens to this point is called the focal distance f. Even if the light is shining in an angle onto the lens, as long as the rays of light are parallel, they are going to be focused in a single point. Also, keep in mind that these rays of light don't have a preferred direction. You could also have a point source of light, for example an LED, and use the lens to create a parallel light beam. Next, I'm going to bring back the circle from the beginning. This circle has a radius r. If we increase that radius, we also increase our focal distance. Now look closely, we don't change the position nor the thickness of our lens, only the curvature. We can describe this correlation in a simple formula. The focal distance f equals the radius of that curvature divided by n minus 1. N is called the refractive index and it's just a material constant. For example, the acrylic I'm using has a refractive index of 1.492, which is given by the manufacturer, but you can also find values for many other materials online. Okay, I can hear you asking, what about biconvex lenses, or concave lenses, or even convex-concave lenses? Well, there's one formula to rule them all. You can also rearrange the formula, so it's easy to calculate the focal distance when you have the radii of your lens. However, in most cases it's much easier to work with the upper formula. For example, if we want to calculate the focal length of that plano convex lens from the beginning, we just remove the term with the second radius and then flip both sides. Now let's check out some different lenses. First, a biconvex lens. It has two radii, R1 and R2. These obviously don't need to have the same value, so let's just say R1 equals 10 cm and R2 equals 15 cm. In order to keep things simple, I'm going to set the refractive index n to 1.5, which gives us a focal length of 12 cm. Now look closely at the second circle. We are going to move its center leftwards across the lens. This creates a convex-concave lens, and because the center of the circle crossed the lens, its radius has to be negative. So now R2 equals minus 15 cm, and we get a focal distance of 60 cm. You might already have seen this coming, we now move the first circle rightwards. This creates a biconcave lens, and again, R1 changes into a negative value. This time, our focal distance becomes negative. A negative focal distance might seem a bit weird, but it actually makes sense. If we shine light onto a concave lens, it gets dispersed. However, if we extend those rays of light backwards, they are going to meet in one point, the focal point. Keep in mind that these additional rays are only imaginary. In reality, the light doesn't move backwards. If you compare the concave lens with the convex lens from the beginning, the focal point is now on the other side of the lens, and therefore it has a negative focal distance. Let's apply the things we've learned so far and try to make prescription lenses. I never thought I would say that, but luckily I have to wear glasses. These lenses are labeled with minus 1.25 diopter. Diopter is a measurement unit for the refractive power P, which is defined as 1 over f. That's super useful, because we can just put it into our formula. Because it's a negative value, we already know that it's going to be a concave lens, and in order to keep things simple, I'm going for a plano concave lens. So let's remove that term with the second radius and solve for the remaining radius. Next, we insert all the values. I am using 1.492 for the refractive index. So we get our desired radius of minus 0.394 meters, which is negative because we are making a concave lens. Next, we have to model the lens. I'm using Fusion 360 for that. I start with a rectangle which sets the diameter of the lens, in this case 40 mm, as well as the maximum thickness of 3 mm. Now I add a circle with the radius we calculated before. Keep in mind that Fusion expects a diameter, so I multiply that value by 2. I align the center of the circle horizontally with the origin point and add a coincident constraint to our rectangle. Lastly, I just add one horizontal line in the middle so I can revolve that area around the central axis and the lens is finished. I won't go through the cam settings, however, as I said in the last part, I would suggest using a spiral toolpath to make the lens profile and a 2D contour to cut it out from the stock material. But there's also an even better way to make a lens. I'll present to you a force axis. I don't really want to cram it into this part, and it also isn't finished, so I guess there will be a third part in this video series. After sanding and polishing, this is the final lens. Sadly, there's a crack right in the middle, but it still does kind of work. It definitely improves the sharpness of my vision, but it's nowhere near the performance of my original glasses. Holding it in front of the camera cannot be compared to looking through it with your own eyes, but it clearly shows some of the aberrations. I guess a belt-driven 3D printed CNC isn't the best choice for lenses which require such a high precision like prescription lenses. Additionally, if you look at the real glasses, their lenses aren't flat like the ones we made, but curved instead. I don't want to go into detail about that, but that's also one of the reasons why they perform so much better. But how precise are those lenses we made in the last part? Let's check out the formula. This is a biconvex lens with both radii being 114 mm. Again, I'm using 1.492 as the refractive index, which results in a focal distance of roughly 58 mm. My basic test setup consists of an LED which shines light onto the lens. In order to get relatively parallel rays of light, I am placing the LED as far away from the lens as possible. I'm not really happy with this setup because it doesn't allow me to take precise measurements, but I already ordered some stuff which will hopefully improve the situation. As far as I can tell, a focal distance of 58 mm is pretty much spot on. Again, take this with a grain of salt. However, I'm still impressed with the result. Even with all those approximations and the fact that this lens was made with a 3D printed CNC and has been manually polished, it seems to be fairly accurate, at least with regard to the focal distance. Still, there are problems like spherical or chromatic aberration, which may be a good topic for the next part. Before I end this part, I just want to give one more example how to construct a lens in Fusion 360. This time, a plano convex lens. It's really simple. Start with a circle and add a horizontal line. Then add a midpoint constraint to that line and the origin point. The length of this line is going to set the diameter of your lens, and the radius of your circle can be calculated with the formula I have already shown you. Lastly, add another line so that you can revolve that sketch around the central axis. As you can see, the outer edge gets quite thin, so I would recommend extruding the lower face so it doesn't chip while machining. For all the other types of lenses, like biconvex, biconcave or convex-concave lenses, it's basically the same workflow. Make a sketch with one or two circles and revolve it around the central axis. And that's it for this video, thanks for watching and have a great day!